Hey guys, this is officially my last week of summer and my last week at home with all of my lovely books and this awesome camera. So I wanted to do something to kind of, something special to say goodbye to summer. I thought, what better way to do that than to do an updated bookshelf tour? When I originally started using this channel again, I did a three-part book collection tour in which I actually went through and I pulled out most books and showed covers and talked about them and things like that. I will not be doing that in this tour. I will just be giving you a quick update on the shelves. I'll go shelf by shelf, maybe talk about decorations a little bit, because I basically had a reorganization day at the beginning of the summer and went a little crazy OCD with alphabetizing and categorizing and things like that. So yeah, that's pretty much all you're gonna get in this bookshelf tour. Okay guys, I'd like to apologize for the lighting because I know it's a little weird, but this is the first shelf that I have in my room and this is basically my collection of adult fiction, although there are a few kind of anthologies and textbooks and things like that down on the bottom there, but I am going to go shelf by shelf, and I was going to try to do this with my tripod, but I was having difficulties, so we'll see how this goes freehand. I'm gonna try and be as steady as possible for you guys. Okay, so this is the top shelf, and the idea behind this was originally to be adult series because I have Pride and Prejudice and Zombies over there on the end, and I know Quirk does a series of other kind of weird classics. I have the Stieg Larsson books, Girl with the Dragon Tattoo and The Girl Who Played with Fire, those things. And then the Outlander, the first book in the Outlander series, which I haven't read yet. And then I have my Star Wars books over here because, again, Star Wars fan. And this lovely painting here in the middle, that is something that my friend painted when we were seniors in high school and he was just going to throw it away and I saved it from the dumpster because I thought it was very pretty. Okay, so starting on this shelf, I basically have all of my adult fiction mushed together, organized by author's last name. So on this shelf, I believe I have A through H, and, you know, going from left to right, and then I have a little book angel, book fairy, whatever you want to call that, a Buster Posey pin that I got at the last Giants game that I went to, and then these books here, they just didn't fit in with all of my other books. I don't know if you can see here, move this, they are actually double stacked, so I put some of the odd sized books on the bottom because I felt that I could actually fit more books on the shelf that way, and while it does work rather well, it's really hard to get to those bottom books, and I like this setup because it's fairly organized and all of that, but it is hard to add books to this because it all just fits. So I have a lot of little stacks on the outside of the shelf, you'll see as we go along. Alright, on this shelf we have just more of the same. We have H through P, I believe, and then again some random books here that I pulled out after I had organized and didn't realize that they didn't fit in, and then my lovely little skull that I painted for one of my birthdays. Down here is the very, very last shelf, and as you can see this is pretty much my Tolkien shelf. I mean, that's Tolkien and Mark Twain take over the shelf a little bit, but then I do have a Grimm's anthology here, some textbooks right here, my knitting notebook, that's that spiral notebook, and a little doorstopper that was just too cute to use as a doorstopper. Moving on to these shelves here, this is actually a little hutch that I have that matches the rest of my furniture, and you know, I've got decorations on top, and my books here, and there's a few drawers and things down here, and in this case I generally keep children's and my young adult books and a bunch of children's anthologies and things down here. These are more children's books. These are all of my hardcovers that they just happen to fit better that way because these are awkward sized shelves and they're actually double stacked, so there's a row behind that one, and my Star Wars series are back there. I think I have American Girl books. Then as you can see, this bottom shelf is double stacked as well. I have, you know, a few hardcovers up here, but they're mainly paperback, and then back in the back they're mainly hardcover, and just a few random books that were small and awkward and didn't fit up on the top there. This big stack, sorry the lighting's getting weird again, this big stack right here are my Twilight books and the Host, so basically my Stephanie Meyer stack, a bunch of children's anthologies, let's see, a box of Change, and some random small books. So this next stack of books isn't actually really on a bookshelf. This is actually a doll changing table that my grandfather made for me when I was a little kid, and I use it currently as a makeup table because I don't waste furniture. You can always reuse it for something. And so I've got makeup up on top, magazines and makeup in the middle, and my little collection of hard covers that were either too nice to put away in my cupboard or just too big to fit on my other shelf, which is wire and probably isn't the strongest bookshelf. And lastly, we have this little tiny shelf that is in the corner of the room that is actually new. It's a new addition. I had so many books when I got home from school last year that my mom gave up the shelf so that I could have somewhere to put them. And basically the books on these shelves were all the same size. They're very short books, I don't know if you can tell, but most of them are Signet Shakespeare classics, and then this little stack of old books right here in the front. Okay, moving on to the second shelf. Here in the front we have a couple of school books for classes this semester that I have yet to pack, so they're just kind of hanging out there until I put them in a box, and I'm really not sure what I'm going to do with them once I've finished with the semester. As you can see, I really don't have any extra room on my shelves, but over on the left behind them we have a bunch of different plays, mainly Shakespeare, that I read either during my undergrad or during high school. And then in the middle there is my watch box, and on top is a little Chinese kind of like a pin cushion. I'm not really sure what it's supposed to be, but I've had a couple of those throughout my life and I think they're very cute. And then over on the right there we have a bunch of different short story collections, and they're actually on top of a big fat short story anthology. So yeah, that is my little collection shelf, and this shelf is arranged alphabetically by author's last name within each subsection, and so is the top shelf that I just showed you. Lastly, here we have my Penguin Classics shelf, and I actually will go into organization of this because this was a little bit more complicated. Most of these are from my undergrad years, but this big Penguin anthology of poetry down here, that was from high school, and then the three Jane Austen books on top I will be reading this year for a class, so I'm very excited, and again, I have to pack those. But behind here, these are alphabetized, but kind of differently. Over here we have books that are more anthologies. They don't necessarily have an author's name on them, so I organize them alphabetically within that section. And then over here we have the books that actually have author's names on them, and then again they're alphabetical by the author's name. Okay guys, so that's it. That's the last video of summer 2013 for me. I do start school on the 20th, and my schedule's a little weird this year. I'm not sure when I'm going to be working. I'm not sure how much homework I'm going to be having, and I'm going to be working on law school applications and LSAT testing and things like that. So I don't want to definitively say how many videos or what kind of videos I'll be posting, but I will be doing my best to at least update you guys every once in a while. Anyways, I hope you guys are having an awesome day. I will see you next time in my next video, and I hope that is very soon. Bye! Hey guys, I am currently editing the video that you just watched, and I realized that although I mentioned that I'm not sure when I'll be uploading my next video, I didn't mention that I will still be posting on my blog and of course on Twitter and Instagram and things like that. So if you would like to follow along with what's going on in my life aside from here on Booktubia, feel free to come follow me on any of those platforms. All of the links are always down below in the down bar, so check that out, and yeah. Hope you guys are having a great day. Bye.